John Foreman is one of the finest maestros around, and he's put together a concert for Mother's Day, which will feature a very special guest, Paddy Newton, performing for the first time since her beloved Bert passed away.
Yeah, John is the musical director of the Aussie Pops Orchestra, who Paddy will be performing with. And for the first time in almost 3 years, we're so lucky that he's in the studio with us. John, it's such a pleasure.
Bring it in for the real thing, John. Right? Come on, up we get.
Are we allowed?
I think we're allowed now.
Only me on this one. It is so good.
It's been too long.
It's been far too long, hasn't it? It's been years, actually, since I've actually been here.
Crazy.
And I've only ever seen you on the monitor.
Right.
Only ever, yeah. So it's great. How much fun is it now to be, or at least seems as though everything's coming back to normal?
Well, yes, except that I must say, your studio looks great, but it doesn't smell as good as it used to. Something's gone terribly wrong.
Our last guests were very, very nervous.
Right. Yeah.
And had a bit of a bathroom issue.
Right.
But if you feel the same, John, feeling a bit nervous, we've got a clean-up team on standby ready to go. But this is so beautiful because this is the first time that Paddy will be performing. How is she feeling about that?
Oh, look, I think she's excited to be performing again. I must say, I think she was a little bit reticent when we first spoke about this, whether she wanted to sort of get back on stage or not. But, she's a pro. She's been performing since she was a kid. And I think, I've been thinking about, all of the skits and comedy and stuff that we've been watching after Bert passed. And, the thing that people sometimes forget about Paddy is what a great singer she is.
Yeah.
She performs. And in fact, the first gigs that I did with Bert and Paddy were music performance shows up in Twin Town Services Club before any TV, and Paddy was singing as part of those shows. So it's Paddy together with David Hobson, who's absolutely brilliant. Everybody loves David, and Harrison Craig, who was one of the first winners of The Voice. So that combination, I think, will be great with the orchestra for Mother's Day.
Oh, most definitely. Because Paddy for almost 30 years now.
Yeah.
Is there any of the early gigs that kind of stand out for you that you remember?
Well, it's funny. The very first job I did with Bert and Paddy was at Twin Town Services Club. It was before I'd done any television work with Bert at all. And Bert, I think, was dressed up as Conway Twitty and Paddy was Dolly Parton. And so there was lots of fun and sort of humour and all that sort of thing, as part of the shows. But amongst it all, Bert was a great singer too. He did a lot of work in musical theatre and had a lot of great roles where he had to sing and dance to some extent and act. And Paddy, of course, has always been a great singer. So, yeah, I think that's one that stands out as one of the great early gigs with Bert and Paddy.
And working with them so closely as a couple too, you would have seen how much love there was between the two of them. It was quite an amazing love story that they had.
Yeah. And of course, for your younger viewers who may not know, I mean, this was before my time, but their wedding was like, a royal wedding, covered in all of the newspapers and on television, all that sort of thing. It was quite a big event at the time. And, yes, they stuck together for so many years. It was a showbiz wedding or marriage success. They made it work, and I think it's because they supported each other throughout all of the years. And I would like to think that Bert is sort of looking down from wherever he is now, saying, you go get him to Paddy, because, she's a trooper and she's a great performer. And I think he would want her to be getting back on stage and performing again.
Yeah, the closest thing Australia has to royalty,
yes,
you could say. And now coming up for the show, we've got the fabulous Art Paulini, someone you helped make a star as musical director of Australian Idol.
Well, Paulini is a fabulous, fabulous performer. And, in fact, I saw Paulini even before she was on Australian Idol. She was one of the stars of the School Spectacular way back when.
Wow.
And I don't know if it's still on YouTube, but, she was just absolutely brilliant when she was on the School Spectacular. So Australian Idol came along and I thought, oh, this is great. Australia will now get to hear it in even more regular performances from Paulini. So, yeah, she's brilliant, and I'm excited to hear what she's got coming up. Is she talking to you today or later in the week?
Not only that, she's performing.
Today she's performing.
But when you see
kind of
the alumni of of Australian Idol way back then, and you see them doing great things, you must feel a bit of a sense of pride that I helped do that. I helped shepherd them.
Oh, look, it's not so much what I did, but I'm proud to see that they've all flourished, or so many of them have, I mean, it is a very tough world out there in terms of music, especially the last couple of years. The music industry has been hit pretty hard.
Mm.
So to see people like Paulini and Guy Sebastian, of course, and Anthony Clare and Ricky Lee, and, the list goes on and on and on of performers that are doing so well. Jessica Malloy, of course. So, yeah, I'm proud of what they've achieved, for sure.
Oh, yeah, we can't wait for this. John Foreman's Aussie Pops Orchestra presents Mother's Day concert is, of course, on Sunday the 8th of May at Hamer Hall in Melbourne. You can head to the Arts Centre website for all the details on that, but it should be a fantastic event. John Foreman, let's not leave it another couple of years, please.
I'm here whenever you want me. Right, lovely to see you both.
It's a pleasure to find you. Too.
Just superb. Clean the place. Yeah.
We've gone to the dogs. What can we say?